Hello, hello Scorpios. Welcome to your May reading. If this is your first time stopping by, please subscribe to my channel. It does help me a lot to continue making these videos for you guys. Thank you so much. I appreciate your support. I want to wish you all a great month and let's get started with the first week. So we start with the Sun card and I'm feeling you guys being very happy, very optimistic during this first week of May. You might decide to change something about your appearance. You might decide to change your hairstyle or hair or get a haircut or the color or you know buy some new clothes. Just spice things up. The summer is coming. You're feeling more energetic. You're getting your energy level is back. You're feeling more optimistic about the future. You're more likely to be able to express yourself more during this week. You want to be yourself, you want to release your creativity, you want to show aspects of your personality that you might have kept hidden. Now it's the time for you to be able to release that, and you will draw attention, especially singles. I'm feeling this is a good week to meet someone, okay, start this beautiful love romance. Couples, if you've been having any types of disagreements with one another, or if you were broken up, there's a good chance of getting back together and reliving that beautiful romance from scratch. Some of you might even want to go on a vacation, spend time together, spend time with family, friends, loved ones. So it's time to celebrate and enjoy life. Okay, enjoy who you are, release that inner child within you, be happy, be playful, flirt, you know, enjoy good food, enjoy good company, don't overthink things so much. That's what I'm feeling with the sun card. This is also a great time for those of you who might be planning to get pregnant. It's a good time for that. It's connected with that fertility energy. And I'm also feeling that health-wise, for those of you guys who might have had any issues, if you have felt sick prior, or if you haven't felt 100%, during this week, you're going to get your energy level back up. You're going to feel more energized. You're going to feel better, strongly about yourself. And you might also get good news, or things are going so well in your life that you're just content. You're happy. You're present in the moment. You're enjoying all the little things in life, and you're happy with who you are, what you've accomplished, and the people there, and you feel grateful for everyone that is around you. Now, this energy kind of shifts a bit in the second week with a Page of Swords, because I'm feeling, Scorpios, there's someone around you, someone in your circle of friends or co-workers or people that are very close to you, that they're not acting how they actually are, okay? So this person is trying to stir things up. This person has a hidden agenda, but they're completely different. The way they act towards you when they're around you is completely different. They're trying to gain as much information and knowledge from you and then use that against you, okay? So you can't really see the true colors of this person. You can't see their face. They're hiding. They're manipulating. They're lying. They is that double-sided when someone shows you something else and they're completely something else. That's what I'm feeling with the Page of Swords. And you might be dealing with someone that has their ascendant or their sun sign, either in Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius. This person is very smart, very intelligent, but they're using their wit that they have, they're using it against you. They're using it to manipulate this particular situation. So try to be more aware and try to be more careful who you're sharing your information with. I'm also feeling that you might be getting some bad news or gossip, or you might be getting some, this person is bringing you something, okay? So saying, this person might be saying, look, this other person talked about you, they said this and that, or they are trying to lead you in the wrong direction. So try to not overthink, try not to overreact when this person brings you this news, and ask yourself, okay, but what is their interest? What are they benefiting out of this particular situation? Yes, he's telling me that, or she's telling me that. Well, what What does she have to win? Okay, because if they're truly your friends, then why they're talking about you? Why are they gossiping for you? You know, while they're doing that, why they're allowing someone else to speak against you? You know, so just tell, you know, try to be as polite as you can and just tell them, okay, thank you for letting me know. I would like to speak with that person myself and have a conversation with them myself. That's what I'm feeling for you guys. So try to be very smart. And if your intuition usually is very strong, Scorpios, you're known to have that very strong gut feeling. If something is telling you that this person is not right, is not genuine, is not 100%, keep things to yourself, okay? Don't share too much. Don't give too much. Just be careful. Be careful in this sense. I'm also feeling for you guys that this person is trying to do all of this because of the jealousy that they might have, because they see the Sun card, they see how well things are going for you, how successful you are, you're the center of attention, you're doing great, you're doing well physically, you might feel great, and they're trying to get some of that spotlight from you, okay? So yeah, it's jealousy, it's jealousy is someone being envious, so be careful in that term. Now, in the third week with the full card, I'm seeing that you're being very smart and very, very cautious. And this is a great representation of Tyrion going to the dragon's den. In this case, you're protecting yourself, okay? You're saying, why is this person offering me an opportunity? Because I see an opportunity being offered to you. But in a way, this is an opportunity to lead you in the wrong direction, because they see that you are in the right direction, and now they kind of don't want you to go that way, and there's like, it's like a way to tempt you, no, see, look, maybe you can get this is easier, but you're thinking, no, I have set my goals, I have my plans, I know where I'm going, so I'm not just going to change everything that I've been planning or working hard for to go towards this direction, okay, because there is something not clear about it, there's something that is telling you to be cautious, to be careful, because you don't know where it's going to end or how it's going to play out, and this is a beautiful energy. You're being smart, you're not really following your heart or your impulsive nature of feeling, oh yeah, this is exciting, let me do this, let me try this. No, you're thinking, no, I gotta think things through. I'm feeling good about myself. I know where I am, I know what I've accomplished in life, so I'm not gonna ruin this, or I'm not gonna lose this for something else. That's the energy that I'm feeling in the third week for you guys. And with the Three of Spears, during this week, it's not the time, especially the last week of May, and this is a time when Mercury goes retrograde, okay? May 29th, Mercury goes retrograde. The chances of having some misunderstandings, miscommunications are very high during this week. So it's not a good week to make any decisions. Plan for the future. It's not a good week to invest your money or make any big purchases, okay? Take the time to really carefully review everything. Take the time to think things through. Use that same logic, that same sense of caution that you've been showing in the third week. Use it in the last week as well. And I'm feeling for some of you guys, for the singles who met this person in the first week, that you had that first spark, that first romantic spark. This person might be traveling, okay? Might be from another city or another country, or they might live far away from you, and they might offer you to have a long-distance relationship. And some of you guys, I'm feeling that you're very skeptical about it. You're telling yourself, should I do this? Is this the right thing for me? Is this the right move? I don't know if I'm okay with having a long distance relationship. What if I don't get the same amount of love and support that I need, or how do I know that the person is really faithful if we're not close together. So yeah, you're being skeptical about this. You had high hopes in the beginning, but now knowing that the person is leaving, that is putting a big question mark into the relationship in terms of your future together. Okay, and for those of you guys who have planned to travel, you might decide to reschedule or postpone things because you don't want to. Something will happen during this last week that it will make you suspicious of traveling. It will make you wonder if you want to do it, if you want to travel, if you actually want to. It will make you doubt if you want to travel, if you want to. You know, see if you want to take the risk. You're not ready to take a risk at this moment in time, okay? And the fact that you're being cautious is very beneficial, because it's not the time to take any types of risk. It's the time to protect what you have, protect your position. As I said, you're feeling good about yourself, you're feeling happy, you're in a good place, so just protect what you have and don't risk anything. From the Oracle of Animals, the animal for you for this month is the peacock, and the message is let yourself stand out and be noticed. And this is exactly what you guys will be doing in the first week. Okay, with the sun card, just picture the sun being the center of our universe, the same way you're in the spotlight. Everyone is looking at you. You made these amazing changes in your life, Scorpios, and everyone is like, wow, you're really doing great. You're doing amazing. One of the most amazing qualities one of the characteristics of a peacock is the beauty, is all the feathers, all the colors, you know, the drawing our eyes to them. The same way you have transformed yourself physically, mentally, emotionally, you're leveled up, you're in a better place, and everyone around you can see that. They acknowledge that about you. It's something beautiful. It's something great that would really help. So don't feel... live in the moment, enjoy that, okay? If you're getting a lot of attention, if you're getting a lot of compliments, say, hey, thank you, you worked hard for this, so enjoy it. Don't feel shy, or don't feel like, oh, maybe I'm not being too grounded. No, enjoy that, you know, you worked hard, it's showing, it's reflecting, so yeah, enjoy it, my friend. Soak up all that beautiful energy. And from the Oracle of Love, the messages: speak the language of love, loving worlds have the power to change lives, including your own. Okay. So yes, speak the language of love. As I said, even with this person, even with the Page of Swords, even though this person is not, you can tell that they're not positive, they're looking to create some type of drama in your life or bring some type of conflict in your life, still try to say it in the best possible way, okay? Because they're coming from a place of jealousy. They're coming from a place of wanting to have what you have. Sometimes when people see someone doing well and being successful, and maybe you might have changed something that they wish they would have changed about themselves, maybe you might have lost weight and they're looking to lose weight, just as an example, okay? Maybe they're trying to do the same thing, they haven't been successful enough, so now they're saying stuff just to make you feel like, oh, you're too vain, or you know you're focusing too much on your appearance, or everything is superficial about you. Don't let that bother you. Don't worry about it, you know. Look on the positive. Focus on what you have accomplished, and also try to be kind, because maybe this person is going to realize, hey, I need to start minding my business, I need to start focusing on myself. And repaying someone when you're being kind to them, even when they're not being kind to you, that can be a wake-up call for them, realizing, hey, maybe I should really change my attitude, because this person is still being nice, even though I'm not being as nice towards them, they're still not acting a certain way towards me. Okay, so that's the energy that I'm feeling with a speak the language of love. It's very important to always say things how you feel, and also, my friends, if you're thinking about this long-term relationship. It's very important to have a clear understanding of where you stand with this person, okay? Because liking someone enough to have a long-distance relationship, you're basically taking yourself off the market. You're basically saying, okay, I'm going to be waiting for you because I think that you're so special and I find so many amazing qualities in you that I'm able to wait for you. Okay, but if you don't feel that, if you don't see all those amazing qualities in this person, and you feel like you can't find that same person around the area that you are or have, then why wait? Okay, so you really gotta ask yourself, is it worth waiting for this person? Is this person this special and this unique that is worth waiting for? Or, you know, it's the qualities that they have, you like them, you're attracted to them, but it's not that wow, that love at first sight, that amazing spark, that wow, that immediate connection that makes you feel like you have to wait for this person because this is your true soulmate. You're never gonna find another person that makes you feel this way to this extent. That's what I'm feeling. And from the Oracle of Healing, message is alternative. Okay, so try to think about different alternatives that you can heal yourself, especially for those of you guys who might have had some medical issues. I'm feeling the first week you will feel better, you will feel good, you will get your energy back, but the Page of Swords, sometimes it's an indication of bad news. So you might have done some type of blood work or some types of, you know, you might have done a checkup or anything of that sort, and you might have gotten some not so positive responses. And this is a time for you to change something about your lifestyle. Maybe try to eat healthy, try alternative medicine, some type, and maybe energy healing, or maybe you know, different methods, whatever works for you that might help you in the long run. Okay, if everything you've tried so far has been working for a little bit and then it's not giving you results anymore, maybe you should think outside the box and try something more healthy, more natural, more organic, something of that sort. Okay, so try different things, even physically, you know, being more active, spending more time in nature, all good things for yourself. And with alternative, I'm also feeling if something is broken, if a relationship is not working the way it's supposed to, or it doesn't feel 100% right, take that time to do things in a different way. Okay, so if you've always tried to be very confrontational, very aggressive about it, maybe try to do the opposite. Try to be sweet and gentle and kind. See, maybe that gives you better results than, you know, continuing doing the same thing over and over again. Okay, my friends. So yeah, this is the messages that I'm feeling for you guys. I hope you enjoyed your reading. Thank you so much for watching, and I see you next time. Bye bye.